Good morning, viewers. Welcome to today's Daily Fountain, the daily devotional guide of Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion. Coming to you from the studio of Anglican Cable Network Nigeria, ACNN, our topic of today is Be Aware of the Tactics of the Enemy. But before we proceed on today's topic, let us pray. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness and mercies upon our lives. We thank you for the miracle that you have performed in our lives today. We thank you because, Lord, there is no one like you. You are dependable. You are reliable. Lord, we pray as we study our word this morning, we ask, O Lord, that you grant understanding. In the name of God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our text is taken from Ezra chapter 4, verses 1 to 6. Now when the adversary of Judah and Benjamin heard that the descendants of the captivity were building the temple of the Lord God of Israel, they came to Zerubbabel and the heads of the fathers' houses and said to them, "Let us build with you, for we seek your God as you do, and we have sacrificed to him since the days of Esarhaddon, king of Assyria, who brought us here." But Zerubbabel and Joshua and rest of the heads of the fathers' houses of Israel said to them, "You may do nothing with us to build a house for our God, but we alone will build to the Lord God of Israel, as King of Cyrus, the king of Persia, has commanded us." Then the people of the land tried to discourage the people of Judah. They troubled them in building and hired counselors against them to frustrate their purpose all the days of Cyrus, king of Persia, even unto the reign of Darius, king of Persia. In the reign of Ahasuerus, in the beginning of his reign, they wrote an accusation against the inhabitants of Judah and Jerusalem. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Once again, the topic for today is Be Aware of the Tactics of the Enemy. The enemy, the devil, comes with a threefold agenda of stealing, killing, and destroying. So you can see in John chapter 10, verse 10. The enemies in our text were the Samaritans, the offspring of the intermarriage between those exiled in the northern kingdom of Israel by the king of Assyria and the Jews who remained in the land. They came craftily to the Jews, pretending to want to help in the building of the temple. Consider their tactics. Number one, they claimed they wanted to help because they too believed in God, which was a lie. Today, I pray for somebody that whoever comes to you pretending to be a friend, God will expose them in the name of Jesus Christ. When the Israelites refused, they tried to discourage and terrify them and disrupt the building project. Verse 4. They hired counselors to frustrate their work from the reign of King Cyrus to that of King Darius of Persia. Verse 5. They lodged accusations against the Jews during the start of the reign of King Ahasuerus. Verse 6. All in an attempt to stop their work. Do you recognize the tactics the devil uses to try to destroy your work, business, family, church, fellowship? Christians need to be watchful and prayerful, as Christ advises in Matthew chapter 26, verse 41. Beloved in Christ, the devil is on the rampage. He's looking for people to devour. His own tactics, his own way is to deceive people. And today, we have been encouraged to watch and pray. Prayer is the key. Jesus started with the prayer and ended with prayer. Our God is dependable. There is nothing that he cannot do. In John chapter 10, verse 10, the Bible said that the devil is going about like a roaring lion, looking for people to devour. His own agenda is to disrupt, is to disorder, is the accuser of brethren. And so, Satan, he has some strategies against the people of God. One of the strategies is, number one, to confuse, to cause confusion, to disturb, to deceive, to disorganize. But by the grace of God, you will not be misled, you will not be deceived. The grace of God will abound in your life, so that as you step out from your house this morning, the hand of God will rest upon your life, and you will never be deceived in the mighty name of Jesus. The enemies whose aim is to use pain and pleasure to make us blind, stupid, and miserable forever. But the Bible calls him the devil and the Satan, the deceiver of all the whole world. He is the accuser of the brethren, as it is written in Revelation chapter 22, or Revelation chapter 12, verses 9 to 10. The ruler of this world, John chapter 12, verse 31, and the God of this age, as we can see in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4. He is our adversary, who prowls, who goes around like a roaring lion, seeking for someone to devour. The devil is not happy when the children of God are living in peace. His own agenda is to cause confusion, is to disrupt, is to scatter, is to kill. But Jesus Christ has come to give us life. We remember the temptation of Jesus Christ in Matthew chapter 4, verses 1 to 11. The devil came and tempted Jesus Christ, but Jesus said, "It is written." As believers, we must be rooted in the scripture. The word of God is our weapon. The word of God is our guide. When we study the word of God diligently, the devil will not have access into our lives. We must be combatant. We must arm ourselves with the word of God. Because Psalm 119 verse 11 said that the word of God have I heard, that I may not sin against thee. The word of God is our weapon of war. When we arm ourselves with the word of God, the devil will not near us. In Ephesians chapter 6, verse 11. Please open with me Ephesians chapter 6, verse 11. The word of God said that we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers of darkness of this world. Our fight is not of this world. Our fight is a spiritual war. When we arm ourselves with the word of God, the word of God can do violence to the kingdom of darkness. And so, as believers, we must be focused, we must be determined, we must be connected with our Lord Jesus Christ. When we are connected, the devil will not have access into our lives. I pray for you this morning that the devil will not scatter the plan of God concerning your life. The devil will not have access into your lives in the name of Jesus Christ. The devil does not have a free hand in this world. He is on the leash so that he can do no more than God permits. In effect, he must get permission, as in the case of Simon Peter, where Jesus discloses, "Simon, Simon, behold, Satan has asked to have you, that he might sift you like wheat." Luke chapter 22, verse 31. So the devil has no power. He can only borrow the power from God. He can only do that which God has permitted him to do. In another case of Job, the Lord said to Satan, "Behold, Job is in your hand. Only spare his life." So Satan lies and is the father of liars. He blinds the minds of unbelievers. Satan misparaded, or he is in rampart to confuse the children of God. But when we are rooted, when we are built on the word of God, we will be guarded. He will not take us unaware, because the word of God is our weapon. The word of God is what we can use to conquer Satan. Jesus used the word of God to destabilize the plans of the devil. He said, "It is written, thou cannot tempt me," because the word of God is life. The word of God brings joy. It brings revival. It brings freedom to us men that are in captivity. So Satan does signs and wonders. Satan also tells people to sin. So this is what he did to Jesus, to abandon the path of suffering and obedience. But Jesus Christ told him, "It is written, thou shalt not live by bread alone, but by the word of God." The word of God is our weapon of warfare. When we are connected, when we are grafted in the word of God, Satan will not deceive us. I prophesy that those who come to you pretending to be your friends by the grace of God, they shall be exposed in the name of Jesus Christ. You must recognize the tactics of the devil that he uses every day to destroy the people of God, to destroy family, to destroy businesses, to destroy church, even to destroy the fellowship. Today, we have a lot of people whom God, who devil is not, they have not come in form of believers. But the Bible said that we must shine our eyes because we are in a perilous time. The time that we are in now, we must shine our eyes because the devil is everywhere, is going about deceiving people. But when we remain connected with God, we will not be taken unaware, because our God is dependable, our God is reliable. Whatever he said he will do, that is what he will do. Satan causes some people to, you know, he causes a lot of sicknesses and diseases. Satan is a murderer, and he is bloodthirsty. He's going about looking for people to destroy. But when we remain connected, when we are rooted, when we are grafted on the word of God, we will not be taken unaware. My prayer for you this morning is that may you never be deceived. May Satan never scatter your home. May Satan never scatter your business. May Satan never scatter your family in the name of Jesus Christ. Even as a church, there are many people today who are coming to the church in form of believers, but there are devil in the cassock. And so, as believers, we must shine our eyes so that we will not be... The Bible said that we should test each spirit to see whether it is from the God. You know, a lot of people are out today, you know, performing a lot of miracles, but some are not from God. And that is why you must study the Bible, because the Bible is our guide. The Bible is what we use to conquer the devil. And I pray this morning that as many who may be facing some oppositions, facing some trials and temptation, you must remain and be rooted on the scripture. And as you do so, the Lord will help you in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Father, help, O God, to watch and pray so that I do not fail pray to the enemy in Jesus' name. Amen. O Lord, Father, you are dependable. You are reliable. We thank you, Lord, for the word of God this morning. We ask, O Lord, that as many family who are passing through some challenges this morning, O Lord, as many have been tormented by the devil, let there be deliverance. Let there be restoration in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, arise and let the enemies be scattered. Set free your children, as many that are under the captivity of the enemies. Lord, let them receive their freedom this morning. Thank you, Abba Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. So we thank you for fellowshipping with us today. We encourage you to tune in the same time, same station tomorrow, by the grace of God. Another special edition. If you are led to support and sponsor this program, contact the numbers and the email on your screen. And may the Lord bless you. Amen.